Well, today is the day for the Virginia Tech Hokies as they look to go to 7-6 with a win in the annual 11th annual Pinstripe Bowl against the Maryland Terrapins. Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. There it is. Quite a venue for Tech quarterback Connor Bloomrick to make his first career start as a quarterback, but the game would not start well for Tech. As you see coming up right here, this 92-yard punt return by Tarheeb Steele, the longest in Maryland history. Terps take a 7-0 lead. Stayed that way until the second quarter. Hokies trying to get the O going. How about Bloomrick? Going to go to the air. He's going to hook up with Jaden Payo. Going to the pay window for 42 yards. That would lead to a John Parker Romo field goal from 36 yards, trimming Maryland's lead to 7-3 there. But the Terrapins didn't waste any time. Aaron Talalova going deep, and I mean deep, to Darryl Jones. Who? Darryl Jones, 70 yards to the house. His first career score, the longest TD pass in Maryland Bowl history, made it 14-3. And the Terps, they were not done. They're going to extend the lead courtesy of Antoine Littleton. Takes the rock over the goal line for the 4-yard score. Maryland up 21-3, but the Hokies, they will not give up just yet. In fact, how about Bloomrick, the quarterback for the Hokies? He's going to hook up with Malachi Thomas. He's going to convert the third round, get inside the 5-yard line. A couple of plays later, it'll be Bloomrick calling his own number, taking it in from 3 yards out. Tech gets within 11, trailing 21-10. The first touchdown of the day for the Hokies. It would be the only touchdown for the Hokies on this day. Maryland rolled in the second half, outscoring Tech 30-0 to get the 54-10 win over the Hokies. David Guzman putting a wraps on this game from the Bronx.
Well, there may have been more Virginia Tech fans than Maryland fans here at Yankee Stadium, but the Terrapins clearly scored more points than the Hokies. Their 54 points were the most ever scored by a team in the short history of the Pinstripe Bowl. Meanwhile, for Virginia Tech, it's the worst loss that they've ever suffered in a bowl game in program history, ending J.C. Price's short run as interim head coach. Here's reaction from him after the game.
One game is that to find who those guys are in that locker room. It's, I think it's a situation where you just, it's like plowing a snow hill. It's like you're plowing snow uphill. Eventually, eventually, everything just caught up to us. And we didn't have enough tonight.
You know, just tips off to those guys. You know, they just made plays and we didn't. I mean, that's just what it come down to. No excuses. It obviously sucks that, you know, it finished out the way that it did. But, you know, like you said, you know, a lot of teams didn't even get to play. We had to play when in New York. In Yankee Stadium. So, you know, we are blessed.
Plenty of history made by Maryland in this Pinstripe Bowl, including by quarterback Talia Tagovailoa, who tied the school record for most touchdowns in a single season. Meanwhile, for Virginia Tech, J.C. Price said after the game that a lot of the young guys have a bright future ahead of them, as now it's time for Brent Pry to take the reins, and his era begins next fall when the Hokies open the season at Old Dominion. For now, local at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, David DeGuzman, WFXR Sports.
And thank you so much, David. He did an outstanding job with the coverage up there, and he just mentioned something that's crazy. I mean, you know, the next time we see the Hokies on a gridiron will be in September. So it's 9 months away, but there's still other stuff that's coming down the pike for the Hokies.
Yeah, I know a lot of Hokie fans are excited for Brent Pry and the future of the program.
New page.
All right, so it's almost.